Hey, welcome to Grade 10, Grade 10 Essential. So this is the overview for the Grade 10 Essential Math course. So there's what we'll learn right there. So those are the way I designate my units. Other teachers might label them differently. Our first unit, Unit A. Well, how to solve problems. Right? And not everything is numbers, you know. Right? There are ways to solve. There's usually get a lot of problems that don't have many numbers in them. Right? So you can usually draw diagrams or look for a pattern. There's other things besides just grabbing a calculator and typing in numbers. Have you ever gotten one of these in your Facebook? Probably lots of them, eh? Right? 3 anchors equals 30. An anchor plus 2 sailboats is 20. An anchor plus 2 suns are 9. And then what would they all add up to be? All right. Well, how would you do something like that? All right. So that's called problem solving. Right. This isn't something you just grab a calculator, type in 2 numbers, and boom, there's the answer. This isn't arithmetic. This is thinking. This is logic. There's lots and lots of ways to solve these problems. So let's just try this kind of method here, right? So you could draw it. You could say an anchor plus an anchor is 30. And then you'd say, well, what plus what? 3 of what makes 30? Right? And you go, oh, well, that's obviously 10. Or maybe if you're familiar with algebra, you'd say, well, 3 somethings equals 30, so that 1 something must be 10. Right? That's called algebra. Do you remember doing algebra? If not, you could have just done it this way. There's more than one way to use your logic. All right, how about the next line here? So now we know that an anchor plus 2 sailboats adds up to 20. All right, so we already know that the anchor's worth 10, so the 2 sailboats must be another 10, because that would make 20, which means each sailboat must be 5. Right. Okay, so now we got, right, or you could have said, you know what you could have said? You could have said 10 plus 2 zs, you know, maybe you're going to let z equal the value of a sailboat, is 20. And then you take away 10 off both sides, so 2 zs is 10, which means 1 z must be half of that, which is 5. Right, so that's called algebra, if you remember your grade 9 algebra. If not, don't panic yet. All right, so far we've gotten there. So now we know an anchor is 10, a sailboat is 5. Let's do the next line here. This is all called logic, and you got to be slow and methodical. If you're just expecting to pick up a calculator, type in 2 numbers and hit equals, that's not mathematics. All right, that's arithmetic. All right, so we know the sailboat's 5, so 5 plus this, what are those two things? Those two things must be worth 4, which means they're 2 each, right? So if the both of them are 4, they're 2 each. Hey, I think we solved the puzzle so far, so we know that a sun or a light or whatever that is 2. All right, so let's solve this then. What's a sailboat plus a light plus an anchor? All right, well, isn't it going to be 10 and 5 and 2 is 17? Sweet, all right, so, yeah. So that's called taking your time and solving a problem, right? Sometimes it might take you 3 minutes, right? 3 minutes is pretty good, but not everything's grab a calculator and smash in some numbers, all right? And, of course, there's usually, whenever you solve a problem, there's usually a good way to go back and check to make sure that you've got it right, all right? So, yeah, we had it right, all right? A lot of people are good at Sudoku, that's math. Right, a little bit of arithmetic there. Anytime you use logic, that's called math. Math is the search for truth. All right. Oh, here's a good thinking problem. Right? How about some logic here? All right. Or maybe you want to make a simpler version of the problem. Or maybe you want to do step by step and figure it out. Or sometimes drawing it out would help. There's all kinds of ways to do math without just grabbing a calculator. So pause this. Think about it. Right? Do it. Have you got it? Okay, I'm coming back. Here it comes. Here's one way to do it. So this is your Unit A, games, numbers, problem solving. All right? So there we go. I'm just going to put 5 people down there, right? There's 5 students. So I put Albert, Bruce, Carla, Debbie, and Elijah. And they're going to each shake hands. So A shakes with B, B, and A shakes with C and D and E. All right? So there was 4 handshakes so far. All right, so I'm taking my time, doing it nice and simple, drawing it out step by step, Take your time. It might take 3 minutes. And then B, well, B already shook hands with A. They don't have to shake again, so B gets to shake with three people. Can you kind of see him crossing the floor? And then how about C, right? C is going to shake with two people because C's already shaken with B and A. All right, and then D is the last guy left over. He walks across and shakes E. So there was 10 handshakes, right? So there's one way you could have done it by drawing it out. Or you could have maybe done something like this, all right? So if we still got Albert, Bruce, and Carla, and Debbie, and Elijah, what could they do? Instead of doing it like a big pentagram like this, you could just go like that. There's four. And then, of course, B's already shaken with A, so he goes to C. By the way, you're not allowed to shake your own hand, right? So can you kind of see how math is actually patterns, right? Math is looking for patterns. If you can see patterns in things, then you're doing math. It's not just numbers. All right, so there was another way to do it. How about this way then? All right, or you could have done it this way. There's lots of ways. There's a button on your calculator does this, by the way. All right. So which method did you want to use? So, yeah, I'll give you some suggestions in this unit on how to think, but I'm not going to tell you how to think. All right. So maybe you want to do it like a table or something. Maybe you want to do it like this. All right. Let's put a tick mark every time you shake his hand. Well, guess what? You're not allowed to shake your own hand. Okay. All right. So A shakes with B, C, D, and E. There we go. Now, B and A already shook hands. See, B and A already shook hands. So B doesn't have to go and talk to A now because they already shook hands. Can you kind of see there's going to be a pattern here? All right. Can you look at this? The search for patterns. That's what math is. Math is not numbers. If somebody told you that math is all about numbers, they're wrong. It involves thinking and drawing and making tables and graphs and step-by-step logic. All right, so lots and lots of ways to think about it. All right, you could have used some logic and done some other things. It would be up to you. All right, thinking is a good thing. All right, how about Unit B, personal finance? Personal finance, that's how your paycheck works. All right, so when you get paid, how much do you get to keep? All right, so here's a typical example, read and do, right? Vanessa worked the following hours, so Monday 8 hours, Tuesday 6, Wednesday 9, Thursday, Friday, Saturday. Her regular pay is $13.50 every hour. She gets overtime, right? That's that extra premium pay when you work more than 8 hours in a day. Let's calculate her pay because we'll be doing lots of this in Unit B. All right, so she had 8 regular hours, 6, 8 there, plus 1 overtime. She didn't work on Thursday. She had 8 regular hours and 1 overtime. All right, so we're just going to make, right, we're going to organize our thoughts. We're going to be neat and methodical. It might take you an extra 30 seconds to be neat and methodical, right? And then you add them up. You're going to want to be writing this down on paper, right? You need a pencil and paper to do most math. You don't just grab a calculator and start smashing numbers in. So 38 hours of regular time at $13.50 for every 1 hour per hour. So let's see. That's going to work out to, let me get up my calculator. Oh, here, I'm going to do it over here. Right? Do you know how to do math without a calculator? Do you know how to multiply without a calculator? Yeah, we might want to practice doing some basic arithmetic like that. When I do it this way, right? Watch, did you see me do it there? Right? I went like that. Here we go. I went 13.50 and all that. Remember all that stuff, right? I ended up with $513. And then, of course, I took out my calculator. And it said, surprise, it's $513, right? So, yeah, it doesn't hurt to practice your arithmetic. And when I do this one, multiply this out. So $13.50 an hour, plus he gets that extra half pay. So $594, all right? So the total is $594. That's his weekly pay. Not bad, right? And then you'll get more problems like this. It gets even funkier now, right? Wow, wait till you get to these, and you got to calculate all his Canada Pension Plan contributions and his retirement plan. And, oh, yeah, it gets funkier than, like, this is a typical problem. Crazy, all right? So how about Unit C, measurement? right? Everybody, you got to know how measurement works, right? So we use the metric system in Canada. The only people that still use that old silly system with pounds and feet and all, that's Americans. Only Americans still use that. So, of course, hopefully you're familiar with the metric system. All right, we'll be doing lots of that. And, yeah, this is, we got rid of that old system with pounds and miles and feet and stuff. We got rid of that back in 1973, almost 50 years ago, we got rid of all this stuff. But we still got to know how to do it, right? Because our neighbors south of us do it. All right, so here's, and then, of course, you got to know how to read a ruler. And guess what? Reading a ruler involves some fractions. Okay, so knowing how to read a ruler, you got to know how to read fractions as well. Sorry about that. So reading a ruler. Why did that go crazy like that? Reading a ruler. All right, there's something funny with my display here. All right, and of course, knowing how to convert stuff might be important if you're trying to change the oil in your car or do something like that. So 8,000 kilometers is the same as how many miles? Right? So, yeah, you pretty simple way to convert. We always give you the conversion table. We tell you that 1 kilometer is worth 0.6214 miles, so 6,214 ten-thousandths of a mile. All right? And then you just put that in your calculator. Once you write, don't just grab your calculator and start smashing numbers in until you've written it down, 4,971.2. Or you could use that old proportion method. Do you remember doing proportions, right? Just like making recipes, right? Doesn't this number just pop up to there? Do you remember solving simple relationships like this with proportions? Right, that 8,000 is just going to pop up to the left there. Now, of course, it didn't really pop up, did it? Right? Okay, so you end up with 4,971.2 miles. All right, next unit that we're going to study is Unit C, right? Geometry. All right, so all about squares and rectangles and triangles and circles. Oh, yeah. And, of course, this is the biggie, right? Pythagoras. Remember that stuff about C squared equals A squared plus B squared? Yeah. Do you remember that stuff, right? If you have a triangle that's 3 that way, and then it makes a square corner there and goes 4 that way, well, then this side has to be 5. There's no doubt about it. Look, right, if I made a square, if I filled that with beads and a square, right, there'd be 3 rows of 3, would be 9 beads. And if I made a square on this short side, there'd be 4 rows of 4, because this is the same as 4, so there'd be 16 beads, and if you added it all up, 9 and 16 is 25 beads. So you'd say, well, what number times itself would give you 25? Well, guess what? That's 5 times 5, right? So that side there has to be 5. Anyway, this is kind of old news. You would have done this a long time ago, maybe really long for some of you. So let's just do it here. So say I give you this right triangle, it's 2.1 centimeters long there, 3.5 centimeters long there, and I want to know this long hypotenuse side. You write down the formula, you plug in the numbers, and boom, there's your answer. So we'll be doing lots of that. Do you remember doing some of that in previous grades? Right? You will want to have a good calculator. One of those Dollarama calculators is not sufficient. And the calculator that comes with your phone, that's not any better than a Dollarama one, to be honest. So you're going to need a proper calculator that does stuff like this. They're about $12, maybe $16 now if you didn't buy them in August. All right. All right. How about trigonometry? All right. The next unit, Unit E, will be trigonometry. Do you remember doing SOHCAHTOA? SOHCAHTOA. All right. Trigonometry. All right. Right there. Trigonometry. All right, so say you're out with your daughter flying a kite, and you know that your string is 45 meters long, and your daughter says, Mommy, how high up above the ground is the kite? So there's your daughter standing right there looking straight up, because when you look straight up, you're looking at a 90-degree angle to the ground, aren't you? Looking straight up. And so she wants to know how high up it is. Well, obviously, it's less than 45, right? So, yeah, you could probably eyeball it. All right, so let's do the math. So you label your corners, right? Here's where you are. Here's your hypotenuse. Remember that word, hypotenuse. Here's the side that's opposite to the corner. And you're measuring this corner here, this 62-degree angle with your phone. You know your phone measures angles, right? Do you know that? All right, so you say the sine of the angle, the opposite divided by the hypotenuse. And then you plug in some numbers. The sine of 62 is the opposite side. Well, we don't know how long it is, so we call it x divided by 45. And then this just pops over to there, doesn't it? Well, it doesn't pop over to there. We make each side 45 times bigger. So if we make this side 45 times bigger, right? Well, that'll get rid of the divide by 45. But if we do the same on this side, well, now they're still equal. All right, so that's called algebra. So we're going to solve it using algebra. We're going to multiply both sides by 45 to undo this divide by 45. Boom. Now you know that the x is 45 times sine 62. All right, so your kite is 39.73 meters up. And you figure that out just by using your phone. All right. Notice you need a decent calculator. If you plan on doing this course with a Dollarama calculator or just the one on your phone, it's not going to work too well. Oh, how about this? Unit F, consumer decisions. All right, so what's the matter with this picture? So it's all about smart shopping, exchange rates, if you buy on the internet. What's the matter with this picture? This is an actual picture from my Shoppers Drug Mart. And it says sale right here usually too. Do you get tricked all the time? Check this out. Two of these would be what? If I double that, isn't that going to be 324? So two of these would be 324. So if you wanted 2 liters of milk, you'd buy two of these and it would cost you double that, which is 324. You could do that in your head maybe. Whereas you could buy the same amount of milk, 2 liters, for $3.79. Oh my God, you're being ripped off by 55 cents. And it says sale. Don't be tricked. They do this to you all the time. Did you bother to compare prices? If you didn't, you're being ripped off by thousands a year because you didn't bother to compare prices. So that's what that's all about. And we'll check out money exchange in case you buy stuff on the internet. All right. Then unit G is going to be transformations, you know, so reflecting a shape. So we'll take different shapes and we'll reflect them across some line and we'll rotate them and slide them and stuff like that, just like your PlayStation does. All right, so, yeah, we'll be using Cartesian coordinates. Remember doing coordinates like this on grid paper? Remember doing your X's and your Y's? All right, X's and Y's, and then this shape is going to reflect over to this side like that. So we'll be doing some of that. I'm just showing you what we're going to do. All right. Protractors in Unit H, we'll learn how to use protractors and make angles and things. So this measure here is just like using a ruler. You start at a 0, 0, 10, 20, 30, 40. So that'll be a 40-degree angle. And, of course, you know what this is, right? Isn't that going to be the supplement? Won't that be 140? All right, so we'll learn all about protractors and angles. What else have we got here? Okay, and then the final, I like to sneak some high school stuff on you, like prior studies. I like to go back and sneak in some middle school stuff, stuff like fractions and algebra and integers and negative numbers. So, for example, what's 3/4 plus 1/2? Well, you know what? If you've ever had a pizza, it's pretty easy to figure out, right? You ever eat pizza? Here's 3 slices of a 4-slice pizza, and here's 1 slice of a 2-slice pizza. How much pizza have you got? Oh, my God. All right? So you got 3 slices of a 4-slice pizza, and you're going to add... And you got this other half of a pizza, so that's 1 slice of a 2-slice pizza. How much pizza do you have? Well, it's just pizzas. Draw them out. Right? The secret way to learn math is to draw pictures. Using numbers to learn math is kind of silly. All right, so notice if I put this piece here, I would have, right, if I put that piece there, I'd have one whole pizza, and I'd still have this one piece left over. So I'd have one whole pizza. Plus, I'd have 1 slice of a 4-slice pizza left over. There you go. So we would call that 1 1/4. So it ends up being one whole pizza plus 1/4 of a pizza. Oh my goodness. So fractions are just pizzas, all right? I don't know how much more difficult we can make it. So if you've ever had pizzas, you've probably done fractions, unless you eat the whole thing yourself. And then we'll do some algebra as well. You know, if 3 hot dogs plus a $5 bottle of Coke equals 26 bucks, how much does 1 hot dog cost? All right, so that's called solving for X. So you take away that $5, which you wasn't part of your X's, so that means the 3 X's must have been worth 21, and you want to... if 3 of your answer is 21, then what's 1 of your answer? So if you divide by 3, they're still equal. That means the X is 7. Right? And don't forget to check your answer. 3 times 7 plus 5 is 26. Woo-hoo. So there, that pretty much is what we're going to be doing. That's a quick overview of grade 10. It builds on previous grades. We might have to do a little work and go back and tweak up some of your stuff from grade 9. But we can do this. Don't forget, you'll need a proper calculator, and you'll need a good attitude, too. All right, so that's it. Load clear. It's going to be fun. Complete.